Hi everyone, it's Dara. And welcome back to my YouTube channel. So for today's video, I'm gonna do my September wrap-up. And I know it's a bit late, but it's better be late than never. So yeah, so let's start. So first off, the first one I read last December was the Kingdom of the Cursed, and I rated this a 4 out of 5 stars, and I really enjoyed the book. Then binasa ko siya ng sobrang bagal kasi ayoko siyang matapos, and I really enjoyed this a lot. Gusto ko yung chemistry between Emilia and Wrath, and I'm excited to read the third book, which is the Kingdom of the Feared, and I haven't got my own copy, but I wish na sana mag-push through yung order ko, because I ordered also a Barnes & Noble exclusive edition kasi naantay ko pa yung confirmation ng bookshop na pinagbilhan ko. But if di sila mag-respond, I might cancel it. So, yeah. I'm excited. Sobra talaga ako nag-enjoy. And hopefully, I would be able to read more of Carrie Maniscalco's books. Especially yung Jack the Ripper series. I'm kinda intrigued by that series. So, yeah. The next book that I've read is The Last Time We Say Goodbye by Cynthia Hand, and this book, grabe akong pinaiyak na tong librong ito, sobra. Hindi siya romance, and I can't believe na ang tagal ko siyang hindi binasa, parang matagal ko siyang binili, pero ngayong September ko lang siya binasa. I think last year ko to binili, pero hindi ko lang tinuloy binasa kasi akala ko hindi maganda. But I'm glad na natapos ko siya this year. And I rated this a 5 out of 5 stars because it was really good. It was really good. But you need to watch out or look up for the trigger warnings because it tackles about suicide. This book made me realize na dapat we should enjoy and appreciate those little moments with our loved ones, friends, family, ganun. Mostly it tackles about family kasi si Lexi dito is nagko-cope siya sa pagkamatay ng brother niya, si Tyler. And actually, na-explain ko na yun sa past vlog ko. And sobra ko siyang na-enjoy, as in. Then the next one that made me also cry is this book, You've Reached Sam by Dustin Tsao. It's his debut novel, and sobrang hype up nito sa TikTok. And ngayon ko lang siya binasa. Matagal ko na siyang binili, pero ngayon ko lang din binasa. Mabilis ko rin tong siyang nabasa. I think this is just 200 pages. Almost 300 pages. And sobra din akong pinaiyak nitong book na to, and I rated this a 5 out of 5 stars. Si Sam dito is namatay na, and then somehow si, what's the name of the girl? Ano pangalan ng girl dito? Si Julie is nagkaroon sila ng way ni Sam para makapag-usap through their cell phones, and yun yung chance nila to say their goodbyes kasi alam naman natin na hindi na talaga babalik sa pagkabuhay yung patay. And this book made me appreciate people more kasi when we kapag pinafocus natin masyado yung ang attention or life natin sa isang tao, kapag nawala sila, we tend to forget the other people na nagmamahal din sa atin, na dumedepende din sa atin. Si Julie kasi simula nung namatay si Sam, parang siya rin nawala kasi hindi siya makausap ng mga friends niya, pati yung brother ni Sam, nalungkot din kasi parang she was pushing people away, ganun. Kasi parang nung nawala si Sam, tumigil na rin yung buhay niya, but losing someone should not be the reason for you to stop there. You still have a life ahead of you, and you must still go on. And I think if we have our own Sam, kung meron man tayong taong nawala or malapit sa buhay natin na nawala, hindi rin naman siguro nila gugustuhin na sa kanila lang titigil yung buhay mo. So you need to move forward. Ayan. So yeah. Hindi ako magaling mag-explain. The next one is, I read it in an ebook version, which is The X-Hex by Aaron Sterling. And it was kind of a rom-com fantasy, and it's about witches. I forgot the name of the girl. Simula yung story during the summer. Nakipag-break yung lalaki dun sa babae, and then parang napikon yung babae or what, then lasing sila noon ng cousin niya si Gwen. And then she accidentally hexed his ex-boyfriend, and then 9 years later bumalik yung lalaki dun sa town nila, and then things happen. Nagkandaleche-leche yung buhay ng lalaki kasi parang umepekto na yung curse. And then silang dalawa, they solving the mystery kung paano mag-break yung curse. And then ayun, nag-reunite yung love. It's like sobrang nakakatawa. And I think I rated this a 4 out of 5 stars. Sobrang akong nag-enjoy, sobrang akong natawa. And I'm excited to read the second book. It's all about Gwen. I forgot the title. Sorry, mahina yung memories ko. And then the next one that I read this last September is the Twilight Saga. And this one, the book one on the Twilight series, which is Twilight. And I rated this a 4 out of 5 stars. And sobrang kong na-enjoy tong book na to. And I must admit na bumabalik yung addiction ko sa Twilight. During parang last year or during the pandemic, 2020 I guess. Yeah, 2020, binabash ko yung Twilight kasi I can't believe nakilig ako nito nung high school. Pero nung pinapanood ko siya in adult me, nag-cringe ako, and natatawa kasi the acting in the movie sucks. And then, first time kong basahin yung book version, and it's not bad like in the movies. And sobra kong na-enjoy to kasi parang mas may personality si Nabella at Edward dito. And it was just so good. Yeah. So, unfortunately, hindi ko natapos yung buong series sa loob ng September because school happened and then I have a job. So, konti yung time. But I'm still enjoying the journey, and yeah, so I think matagal-tagal din akong makaka-get over sa Twilight, and I don't care about people who's hating this book. Pero mas nagmamatter ngayon yung opinion ko about this book. And I really, really love this book. Next is The New Moon. Nabasa ko rin siya last September. And I rated this a 2 out of 5 stars. Kasi, I'm more of a Team Edward than Jacob. And sa book na to, wala masyadong appearance si Edward. And I don't like Jacob. Basta ayaw ko lang si Jacob kasi nayayabangan ako sa kanya. And parang iniisip niya kasi na mas better yung werewolf over vampires. But mas gusto ko si Edward, period. Mas gusto ko si Edward kasi parang mas mature siya mag-isip kaysa kay Jacob. And si Jacob parang may pagka-immature pa. And masyadong pushy si Jacob. And I really hate the part na nilaglag niya si Bella sa papa niya about dun sa motorcycle. I hate it. I really, really hate it. When you promise na hindi mo isusumbong, dapat you keep that promise. Kahit ano pa yung gawing kasalanan ni Bella sa'yo, dapat marunong ka mag-keep ng promise. Hindi ka nang lalaglag ng isang kaibigan. Yeah, I hated that part. It's a no-no for me. Yun. And I think the last one that I read this last month is the An Offer from a Gentleman by Julia Quinn. Kasi parang gusto ko mag-take a break from the Twilight universe. So I read one of the series of the Bridgerton series, and it's An Offer from a Gentleman, and it's a Benedict story, and I think I rated this a 3 out of 5 stars, I guess. I forgot, I'm not good in remembering things. But I also enjoyed the story. It's kind of a Cinderella retelling kasi si Sophie, meron siyang stepmother and 2 stepsisters. And she also had this one magical night na pagka-strike ng 12, she had to go back into their home para hindi siya mahuli ng stepmother niya. And sobrang cute ng story, but what I don't like about this book is parang may pagka-manipulative si Benedict, and also find him very sweet and nice, pero ayoko lang yung manipulative part kasi parang may part na nasa pilitan niyang sinama si Sophie sa London kahit ayaw ni Sophie. And yeah, but still, I still enjoy the relationship between the Bridgerton siblings. Sobrang cute lang talaga nila, yung bonding nila as a family. It's so nice, so perfect, and I wish I also have brothers like them. But yeah, so that was it, guys. Yun lahat. I have a total of 7 books I read last September, and yeah, sobrang saya na marami akong nabasa last month. And I wonder kung ilan yung mababasa ko, because first week of October, I haven't read anything. Oh, I have 1, only The Eclipse, but yeah. I really hope na ma-reach ko yung goal ko, a reading goal ko this year, because last year I haven't really reached my goal. Kinulang ako ng 5 books ngayon. I think nakalahati ko na yung reading goal ko. And yeah, there you have it, guys. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit subscribe. And if you read one of these books, let me know and let's talk about it more on the comment section. And yeah, so see you on my next vlog. Have a great day and see you.